Hey, y'all, welcome back to the Stuff About Money podcast. I am your co-host, Eric Garcia, and this is a special mini-series that I am recording with a guest co-host, friend of mine, Billy Wagner. Don't worry, y'all, Xavier is still with me. Billy owns an insurance agency down in Florida, and we wanted to explore this idea that insurance professionals are givers. My fifth pillar to building financial security is give to others. And Billy and I wanted to have engaging conversations with a diverse group of insurance professionals to hear their journeys of how they're creating legacies for their families and leaving a meaningful impact in their communities through generous acts. And we do all of that in under 12 minutes with each of our guests. So listen in and prepare to be inspired.
It is so great to have Mohammed with us. He has such a giving heart and really want to hear his story. Mohammed, if you can tell us what has been your inspiration or motivation for giving?
I guess I've been brainwashed as a child, right? I guess it has a lot to do with our community, where we're from, right? It's just kind of ingrained in our community, in our culture, that, hey, that's something you do, right? We are from day one, we go to our mosque, or we call Jamaat Khana, twice a day, and we have to volunteer. The whole operations ran by volunteers. So it's like from day one, we have like youth volunteers, where you were a young child, you joined youth volunteers, from day one as a child. So I guess it's just all upbringing. And I guess I would say my religion has a lot to do with it. It's just part of the norm. You have to give. It's just no questions asked, right? So it's just, I guess it's been brainwashed, I would say, is the thing. From child, you had to go ahead and give your time and service in. So that's how it is.
Yeah. Well, it's culture. It's culture and community. Exactly. So we're not, we'll chalk it up to being brainwashed, but it's just
exactly. Yeah. But it is in a way that, when you have a young child, and from day one, you make him do community service from start. As they grow up, that's just ingrained in their DNA after a while, right?
It's a value. Let's put it this way. Exactly. It's a value in your culture. Like any exactly. value really that's taught, in essence, exactly. you're brainwashing, you're teaching, right?
Right.
So it's a value.
Brainwashing, this is negative connotation, but it's not
like, man,
connotation, right?
I've seen the stuff you're involved in, and you don't do it as someone who's brainwashed. You do it as someone who's like cheerful.
Oh, well, you get passion for it.
So tell us a little bit about, because I've seen some of the stuff that you've done over the years, and we've had some offline conversations. Tell us about some of the causes that you support and some of the things that are personally meaningful to you.
So I always, my whole goal in life is to make a difference, right? I tell myself what made me a human versus an animal, right? And the human have the ability to touch people's lives, right? You could be, I hate to use the word Adolf Hitler, touch it in a negative way, or you could be Martin Luther King or Gandhi and touch their lives in a positive way, right? And so my whole goal is to touch their lives in a positive way and leave a mark behind, right? So the cause I work for that I'm passionate about is Alcon Foundation, akfusa.org. It's part of a bigger network of AKDN. And the reason I'm so passionate about that is because I can actually see my work turn into an actual, you could actually trickle down what you did versus, your service, the money you raise, and actually where it went in the cause and people it helped, right? So the Alcon Foundation, what it does, it helps people alleviate poverty all over the world, right? So they go in, what I always tell people is, they go in places where normally people don't want to go to. You take Tajikistan, for example, right? When the whole Taliban thing happened, most of, non-NGO organization left. Mm-hmm. Not AKF and AKDN. We were still there, right? And the whole idea is we work with the community. We see what they want to do, what help they need, and we work with them and not push our agenda, right? So, and that's why we are so successful with building communities, helping communities, and whatever their needs are. So that's one of the main reasons, I'm more passionate about this organization. I could actually see who we're helping, and I could see them coming into the U.S. a lot of times, and you talk to those people and say, oh yeah, AKF did this, AKDN did this for me, and that's why I'm over here. So it kind of motivates you to do more, you know. So it is I can actually see the direct, you know, fruit of my labor in a sense, you know, that's why I'm so passionate about AKF, I guess.
That's really cool. I can definitely see the smile on your face when you talk about it. It's a sense of pride, and it has some correlation to, you know, kind of you're a business owner and you're helping other people, you know, in a different way. And I think it's very unique. So I'm glad that you're sharing that story about it. I wanted to ask you, you know, what is something that was unexpected that you experienced kind of as a result of your giving?
Besides the, you know, the good feeling you get inside, right? The warmness, as I always call it. You know, I hate to put, over time, what ends up happening is because you're in this organization for so long and people get to know you in that organization, the work you do, you automatically get a better self. The praise you get for the work you do, right, helps you feel better and helps you be a better person, right? It's just like being at work, right? If your employer keeps on telling you, hey, you're doing such an awesome job, you did great on this, you did great on that, what happened? That motivates you to work harder, much better, and makes you kind of be part of the team, right? And I think that's what indirectly, me starting off with just, you know, light work, I was a colleague with the organization, to where I'm now, is, you know, it kind of helps build that indirectly. The direct effect you see from your work, at the same time, the praises, the good feeling, the, you know, just the community kind of building you up when you're doing the work kind of helps, kind of, you know, motivates you, keep on going. And, you know, in result, it just kind of helps you become a better person, I feel. It makes you a softer heart, I guess.
It sounds like you're kind of, what you're saying there is like there's like a deeper purpose for the work that you're able to tap into, that that is super meaningful. Something you said earlier that I want to bring back to the surface, and I'd love to hear you talk a little bit more about this. You said you listen to how the people want to be helped, as opposed to push your agenda on them. I think that's really important, particularly for us in the West. We think we know how to always help and what help is always best. Talk a little bit more about how do you listen to the needs of others?
So the organization, the AKF and AKDN, what they do is they work with the community. So they don't go into a community with a set plan. Hey, I want to do this for you. They go in saying, okay, you know what can we help you with? What do you need? Do you have education issues? Do you have medical issues? Do you have clean water issues? And based on their particular need, they come up and include the community and help work on that project. That helps two ways, right? You get self-pride, right? If you're a villager who had water issues, but had no support on how to get the clean water to your community, well, now you are indirectly helping getting water into your community, or medical supplies to your community, or doctors or clinics, or whatever you need. But they work literally with the people there, getting them jobs, getting them employment, and helping them with their actual main issue is, right? So it's versus is you coming in, giving a dollar, you say, okay, no, instead of giving you money or here's the medical supplies, you're gonna say how to, you know, get those sources, how to build then something that you can kind of maintain after you're gone as well, right? So I think that's where, when I say we work with the community and see what they need, their needs are, and help with their needs and not push down what we feel that they need. So
it's interesting that like this has really changed your life in a way, right? You can kind of tell. I would love for you to share, and Eric's got your last question, but I would love for you to share who got you involved in there and how did you get started in it? Like who introduced you to it?
The organization itself, I started a while back, is just kind of helping with registration. It was mostly a friend of mine saying, hey, I'm running this project. Can you kind of help out just the day of, you know, a few hours, right? So once you kind of get in there, you see the passion, the people, and then you start talking to people. I think that's what kind of kicked off the spark and the turn into a fire, right? So I think that's what kind of, one of my good friend, Ahmed Moladina, he's also a business partner of mine. You know, he was running a golf tournament at that time. And he said, hey, can you help me out with the golf tournament? I said, sure. You know, I told him, I don't want to commit to anything big. He said, don't worry, you know, just come in, help with the registration, check people in, and you're done. I said, perfect, that works. And from there, it just was fun. It was, you know, and from there, it just kind of took off.
Yeah, I don't want too much commitment. Now
exactly.
You're like,
I don't want too much commitment, you know.
Now you're and all
next,
in.
And next thing you know, I'm running the whole damn show.
yeah, it's on you, man. It's so, on your shoulders. So exactly. Tell us, you know, we run in a circle of business owners and colleagues and insurance professionals, and insurance people have huge hearts. They're givers by nature. And one thing that's been so much fun about this project Billy and I have been working on is we get to see like how people are involved in giving in such different ways. And it's so cool. And I think that there's so many different ways for people to get involved. And sometimes like we get stuck because like, how do I even start? People aren't sure where to go. Like I want to give, but I don't know how. How would you advise someone who wants to become more active in their community or where do they start?
I think it starts within. You have to do some soul searching, right? Everybody has, you know, there's 10 commandments, but everybody has their own 10 commandments that they live and die by, right? What's important to them? What's their purpose in life, right? If you really want to be considered a human, you have to have a purpose. You cannot leave without a purpose. We're not animals. We're not dogs that come, eat, you know, have kids and then die. That's an animal, you know. If you're not touching somebody's lives, then you're not really, what was your purpose of even coming onto this earth, right? So you have to kind of dig deep in and see, hey, what is my purpose? What is my passion? What do I like? You know, a lot of my siblings are in, one of my siblings love the elderly. So all she does is, you know, elderly care. She'll go to these hospice places. That's her passion. You know, that's where she wants to make a difference. So I guess it all goes back to what is your passion? Where do you want to see a difference being made? Because that comes from your own past experiences, where you felt you lacked as a child. Where do you feel, you know, if I had this as a kid, my life would have been a totally different path, right? So now what you do is, hey, I want to provide that one thing that I missed out on as a child to somebody else so I can change the trajectory of their lives, right? So it goes back to soul searching and see what you're passionate about, where you want to help, and how you want to make a difference in life.
I love that. I love that idea of being self-reflective to start.
That's how you find passion, right? You have to dig deep in. Without that, I mean, otherwise you're just working. There's no fuel, you know? You gotta have fuel. You could do it. You'll be fine by one day. You'll work on one thing and it was fun, you know, and then you kind of forget about it. But how do you add gasoline to that, you know, that little fire that just started? And that's where deep soul searching comes in.
I love it. I love this idea of purpose. That's beautiful. Mohammed, thank you for sharing, man. That's cool stuff. It's always exciting to hear. It fuels me. It fires me up. And I have a heart for, you know, marginalized communities, not just here locally, but around the world. So to hear the work that like y'all are there when no one else is there, you're loving people that like by most measures are quote unquote unlovable. You're bringing dignity to people who have had dignity removed from them. And I think that's a very beautiful thing. And I really appreciate you sharing that.
And we only got one more minute left, but I would just like to ask you the question. Have you gotten other people involved in that organization? And if so, how?
I push my kids to get involved. So my daughter loves the cause now, you know, and then she's been helping out. You know, obviously she's in college, you know, so she, you know, hopefully I'm kind of giving her the Kool-Aid, as I always tell her.
I'm going to feed you.
Brainwashing her indirectly, you know, for what I like to do, you know. But I, at the end of the day, I think everybody needs to find their own passion. But I think when you have a passion and when you have team working with you, it automatically kind of goes on to them, right? And they just kind of feel it, you hear it, and they just kind of run with it afterwards. So it is contagious to a point if you have the same mindset of same purpose. So
yeah, beautiful stuff, man. Muhammad, thank you, my friend.
Not a problem. Take care. Bye, guys.
All right. Take care, guys. See you.